Okay, I think I got one more video before my battery decides to run out. Who will it be? Who will it be? Well, I mean, it's on the title, but as of right now, I'm not sure. I haven't quite chosen. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Just JP. My name is Justin, and today we are listening to the band Audience with the song In Accord. This is a viewer's request by Skinny Vinny. Vinny, thank you so much for the recommendation. We had gone back and forth a little bit, and you chose this song for me to use to get into the band Audience, whom I have never heard of. So thank you so much. Audience is a cult British art rock band which existed from 1969 until 1972, and then 2004 until 2013. Genres, they are labeled as art rock and progressive rock, and that's all I'm going to read about them. This is from their album Lunch. Man, I had a pub sub yesterday. Woo! Down here in the south of the US, we have Publix, which is an amazing supermarket. It has everything, has great food, and they are very well known for their pub subs. Woo! I had a turkey roast beef with American white cheese, lettuce, tomato, mayonnaise, always extra. Always. What did you guys have for lunch? If it's dinner, what did you have for dinner? What did you have for lunch? Tell me. I'm very curious. I like sushi. I'm a big sushi person. You guys like sushi? Join me on Twitter. Join me in the comments down below. Love talking to you guys. And let's just I don't have it pulled up. Let's just get into the song. This is Audience with the song In Accord.
falls the miner's in my stride. If we need to change the tune, we'll change it when we're born. But something tells me by the tone, stays here in the core.
Interesting. I'm going to give you my thoughts after I change the battery because the light's flashing, so I got to go get that. Be right back. So I think the most interesting part of this whole song were the instruments themselves. That was the part that I enjoyed. I really like how the horns came in. The saxophone, was it? Looked like? Yeah, it looks like it was the saxophone. Keith Gurmel, or Gummel. Saxophone, clarinet, and flute. I loved how those came in. I think it was just the saxophone here. I'm not 100% sure. First listens are hard. I like the guitar strumming. I like the drums. Instrumentally, I enjoyed this. The only thing that didn't quite win me over is the singing. Now, as I was listening to it, like I said, the music itself, great. I was enjoying myself. The singing, I didn't quite like, to be honest. But in the last half of the song, when everything kind of dropped off and his singing was in softer tones, then I started to actually like his voice, basically.
I just love the way you move, short and sing the blues.
I didn't quite enjoy his singing there, but...
But something tells me by the tone, stays here in the core.
Here, I like it. It sounds very like old Englishy. He has a, I'm not sure how exactly he's singing, but it sounds like he's singing like this. And the way that his voice is in the softer part, it works. That little intonation, what would you call it? That kind of accent and the way he sings in the softer part works. And I enjoy that part. When he's singing along with the rest of the music and it's a little bit more loud, I wasn't quite won over by that. But what I wasn't expecting, and sometimes that's what I really like, is more instruments in this song than I thought. When I saw the album cover, when I just looked at the band, I was expecting something like folk pop, which is kind of what I got. I see the art rock part of it. But I wasn't expecting like the saxophone to come in. I wasn't expecting the softer and louder tones as they went back and forth. I was just taken by surprise, but it was a good surprise. The guitar's just picking along. See, like, this I like. Like, musically, I liked it. Vocally, I was a bit mixed. It was basically where I'm left. Now, I do think the best part of this actually were the lyrics themselves. I really like how it's written. So, it begins, "I just have to tell you, girl, that I'm in tune with you. You just tipped the scales my way. I saw your notes were true." So already we're getting a love song that's relating music and scales and notes to love and how he sees her. I think that's really cool. "Made my mind up. Now you gotta come and sing with me. Something tells me by your tone, we won't sing out of key." So he sees her. He knows immediately we're going to be in perfect harmony. Our tune, our relationship will always be in key. We're going to be harmonizing. It's awesome. And I love the way he says, "I just love the way you move. You sure can sing the blues. Almost love the way you look more than the tunes you choose. Gotta have you in my band to sing along with me. Something tells me by your tone you're good at harmony." I just honestly really enjoy the way that it's written. "I gotta have you in the band with me. I gotta have you in a I have to have a relationship with you. Join me. Sing it high and sing it low. No matter what happens in it, the good and the bad, we'll always be in harmony. Will always make beautiful music." I just really think that's really cool. And I like how it ends. It says, "If we need to change the tune, we'll change it when we're bored. But something tells me by your tone, we'll stay here in accord." Like, no matter what changes in the relationship, sometimes you're going to have to make certain adjustments in a relationship, right? You got to make certain sacrifices, things change, life happens. But no matter what, we'll always be in harmony. And I literally just thought, a chord, it could be a play on words, a chord. will stay in a chord. A chord is typically made up of two or more notes. Here, two notes. We're two separate notes. We're coming together. We're making a chord. We're making this beautiful sound. I think that's really cool. I don't think I would listen to this particular song again. His vocals did kind of throw me off. I didn't really enjoy them too much. Like I said, I enjoyed the music behind it, but I didn't enjoy the music to the extent that like I would like love to hear it again. You know, I wouldn't mind listening to it in passing, but it's not particularly something that I would type in audience in a chord and listen to. But as always, I do appreciate listening to it, and I enjoyed my listen of it. It wasn't like I didn't enjoy it. There's always like multiple levels. Did I enjoy the song? Yes. Would I listen to the song again? No. You know, there's levels. Would I go out and buy this song immediately? Would I immediately add this to my playlist? Would I play this song immediately after leaving here? Did I love it? You know, there's different levels of where I am. I feel like sometimes I need to explain it a little bit more. When I say I don't want to listen to this song again, or I won't listen to this song again, that doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad song. It doesn't necessarily mean that I didn't enjoy it, because I did enjoy this. It's just not something I would really type in and listen to. Skinny Vinny, Vin, thank you so much for the recommendation. As always, I truly enjoy you guys joining me in the comments and your suggestions. I'm just here to discover new music. A lot of you guys are here to do the same. So let's just keep doing that. Join me on Twitter. Join me in the comments down below. Thank you guys so much. Just JP. I'm out of here. Have a great night.